Hey everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000 with a new LP. I don't know why I'm recording this, I just felt like recording this. As you probably already seen by the title, this is Mega Man 4. I don't know what. Well, actually, I know exactly. Like, I was looking over, I was listening to the music in my collection on my computer to try and get inspiration for something completely unrelated to my LPs, and I just happened to browse into the Mega Man folder and happened upon my Mega Man music, and that made me nostalgic for playing Mega Man on the toilet on my 3DS, which I haven't been able to do since I lost it back in like June. But when I had my 3DS, Mega Man 4 and Mega Man 5 were two of the Mega Man games I'd played the most times. I think I played them both at least 12 times through. So listening to that music made me feel really nostalgic, and I got like two RPGs on my channel going on right now, Final Fantasy V and Super Mario RPG. So I figure a nice action game would do good to offset. Plus, it's been a really long time since I've uploaded two videos a day. I figure if I'm gonna be doing three LPs, this would be the right time to do to get to maybe get back to that for a while. So yeah, this is Mega Man 4. I'm kind of just letting the intro run because I don't really know what else to do. I'm actually recording this. This is the first time I've recorded probably in over a year, maybe. It's the first time I've recorded since before Zelda 2, where I'm actually recording the game audio and my commentary separately. With one exception, the finale of Final Fantasy IV I recorded like that. But this time I'm actually using Audacity. When I recorded the finale to Final Fantasy IV, I just used the split audio and save wave files option on Bandicam, and you wouldn't believe how much hard drive space that shit took up. It was like that episode came out to like 3 gigs in total. It was ridiculous, like including all the parts and like the finished product. But now I'm actually doing it with Audacity because I'm sick of these videos. I'm sick of wrestling with the audio levels, you know? Fuck. So here we are, Mega Man 4. This music is awesome, and you got the helmet on the ground there. It's all symbolic or something, I don't know. If I leave this playing any longer, I'm gonna start busting out into Brental Floss's lyrics to that song from his Top 10 Underrated NES Songs video. That's a good video. You should go watch that. So, we got Ringman, Diveman, Skullman, Brightman, Dustman, Drillman, Toadman, and Pharaohman. Who am I gonna go after first? I like to go after Ringman last. I like to go after Dustman first, consequently, but the thing is, there's one part in Dustman stage that I really hate doing without Toadman. So even though it's cliche, I'm gonna start with Toadman. Oh, you know what else though? I actually kind of like. What the heck is going on with the sound? I actually kind of like coming through this stage with Brightman's weapon, because you can use it to get through this opening segment a lot easier without needing to worry about all these stupid penguin, like flying birds. These flying birds, because birds are so not known for flying or something. Yeah. The music is nice too. All the music in this game is really good. The boss theme gets grating after the 80th time because there's more boss fights in this game than there normally are in, oh my gosh, than there normally are in Mega Man games. Well, with the exception of Mega Man 3, I suppose. Ugh, Mega Man 3! But the boss theme in this game is really like violently shrill or something. Makes it really hard to listen to like for a really long time. But you have to listen to it like 100 times as you play through this game, because there are so many bosses, and only the very, very last one gets his own music. I know, and also, I should probably mention this. I know I've actually LP'd this game on this channel before, but that was back before like my quote-unquote reboot, back when I really sucked. Not that I'm saying I'm like a fucking LP master now, but I think I've certainly improved since then. Back then, I recorded the entire game in, like, I think it was 8 or 9 parts, and I uploaded the entire thing on the same day I recorded it, because I just couldn't wait to get started. What's actually kind of interesting about that was I actually planned to do an LP of Mega Man 5 very soon after that, but for whatever reason, that never got off the ground. That was a long time ago, because I remember the day I was going to record Mega Man 5 was the morning... It was the day before... It was the day before the day I left for camp for the last time I've ever been to camp in my life. The last time I went to the same camp I'd been going to my whole childhood was the day after I tried to record that Mega Man 5 playthrough, and it just didn't take. This guy's annoying. But he's not too bad. I'm not a Mega Master or anything, but I have played through this game like 11 times pretty recently, like within the last 2 years. I can beat pretty much any boss in this game, Buster only. Not on the first try, necessarily, because Pharaoh Man, ugh. Bright Man, ugh. Dive Man hits hard, but if you know what you're doing, you can actually beat him pretty easily. I think I might have the frame rate messed up here, because there are supposed to be energy pellets appearing there, but I don't think they're appearing with the frame skip or something. More snails. Gotta keep drinking that Mountain Dew. Oh, come on. You're gonna be dead soon here, man. You're crazy. There we go. I think we're almost done. We got a little bit here. Oh, this part's annoying. Got these fish coming out of the water. Ah. Yep. Real pain in the dick. Oh, would you stop that? Not much you can do, except... what you can do is not that. I'm getting messed up, man. I don't know what's going on. I've got, like... It's lagging. Oh, my gosh. Well, that was just me being stupid, is what that was. Jeez, do I have to fight that snail again? I think I do. Let's come up here. Oh, I guess I'm full on energy, so even if there were pellets there, I wouldn't be able to hear myself collect them. Yeah, you throw your bomb. I do have to fight this guy again. Sheesh. What did you expect, really? Oh, well. It's no big deal. He's dead already. Yeah, this is the last room of the stage. This one right here. See if I can not fuck this up this time. Dude, what the hell is wrong with you? You're on Minute Maid. Yeah, you just go. You just get out of here. Alright, yeah, cool. I'm glad we understand each other. Now, let's not fuck that up. Thank you. This is not a difficult room. You just gotta not suck. Yeah, I hope I don't die to Toad Man. That'd be really embarrassing, because then I'd get a game over. Then again, if I got a game over, I might be able to go to Bright Man instead, because I also like, because I want to be able to show like how easy the stage becomes if you have Bright Man's weapon. Then again, pretty much any stage in the game becomes really easy if you have somebody else's weapon. This guy can be a real pain in the... I'm actually not familiar with this guy's attack pattern, because all you gotta do is beat him is do this right here. You can actually, it's actually possible to charge up a full Mega Buster shot before he gets his attack off, yeah. It's like pixel perfect, though. Because if you wait for too long there, he gets the rain off and you turn into a, and you get hurt and you can't avoid it, it's a disaster. But, basically just stunlock him and he dies. Easy peasy. And with that, we've beaten our first Robot Master. Boy howdy. That's exciting. You never realize how much silence there is in a game until you record without your own voice. You can see all the silence on the, like, Bandicam. This is how much sound is being input in something. Rain flush. Is that really what that's called? I thought it was Toad Rain. Why is it called Rain Flush? And we got Rush Marine, for what that's worth, which is not a lot. I don't think I've ever used that in this game at all. Okay, let's do Dust Man now. I really hate this guy's stage. This guy probably has one of the hardest stages in the game. Ring Man, officially has the hardest stage in the game. Not that there's ever been an official statement, I'm just trying to find a buzzword. Music's nice, though. Music in this game is all nice. I said that already, but can't say it enough, man. Music's nice, man. Ugh. God, I hate these stupid pit enemies. These guys are in every Mega Man. These stupid shield guys that go back and forth. Just like a classic Mega Man enemy. Oh man, it's possible to make that jump and actually get across there. It doesn't really help you anything. There's not like a secret path over there, but eh, whatever. I think there's a jumbe around here somewhere. I only know this enemy's name because of the Rockman 4 minus Infinity. That's the only reason I know what those things are called. Okay, this is the part where I like to have the Toad Rain, because you can use it to take these guys out easily. Because otherwise, you got those things, like, knocking you into pits and shit. It's a pain in the ass. Ugh, making me nervous, man. Making me nervous. I should go back and watch that old LP, that first LP of this. Just to see what I was saying back then, like, what catchphrases I had. Because I wonder if I was saying, making me nervous, back then. Da-da. This part. Oh, I hate these stupid crushers. The crushers like this in any game always make me really nervous. I hate instant kills of any sort. I just hate them. And this game, like, puts a whole bunch of these... You know what the worst part is? These guys come back in Mega Man 5. Oh, you know what? It's a good thing I got those two lives. Otherwise, I would have been riding on a game over here. That would have been nice and stupid. Yeah, Mega Man 5 has these exact crushers, too. Like, just when you thought you'd had enough of these stupid fucking things. And not have to run into a stupid fucking wall was essential to keeping the game's flow intact. And yeah, just keep running back. I hate this so much. Oh, I made it. Okay. That's like the worst part of the stage, right? I almost dare say that's my least favorite part of the entire game. You know? Fuck. Man, I keep like seeing these areas and thinking, like, wait a second, wasn't this an area in Mega Man 5? Like, no, you're remembering different things. Like, after that Crusher segment just there, I expected to see that segment you see. I think it's in Charge Man's stage, I think it is in a Wily stage or whatever, where there's like a chicken, one of those chicken dispensers, up on a ledge at like the top of a flight of stairs. And you gotta climb up the stairs and kill him. Anyway, here's Dust Man. We're in the trash compactor. I have no idea what that's from. I suspect it's a quote from some animated movie, because it was in the, in the SpongeBob movie game on, Xbox. Like that one. The one that used the same engine as Battle for Bikini Bottom. There were these, like, unlockables you could get, and one of them was, and some of them were, like, voice clips. But as far as I could tell, the voice clips were not actually from SpongeBob episodes, or they weren't clips from the movie. And one of them was, I am the trash compactor! Dude, die. Thank you. Jeez, I didn't even talk about Dust Man. Well, what's there to talk about? We're not playing Rockman 4 minus Infinity. The bosses are just dudes with abilities that they shoot at you, and then you dodge them, and then you shoot them. You know, it's not like he doesn't do the thing that he does in Rockman 4 minus Infinity. Am I gonna keep bringing that up? Ugh, that is so stupid. Where he, like, sucks you up, puts you in an E-tank, and then tries to punt you into the trash compactor. Might be a bill collector coming to put me in the trash compactor. Oh, no! Alright, there's Dust Man. What do we do now? Bright Man's over there? I thought he was here. No, I guess that makes sense. Because if he was over here, then where would Pharaoh Man be? I always remember Pharaoh Man being here, but for some reason I remember Bright Man being on the left. Nobody cares! And we could go to fight Skull Man, that's who Dust Man's weapon is actually good against. Or we could go to fight Bright Man, that's actually who Toad Man's weapon is strong against. I might try to do all the bosses Buster only, just to see if I can do it. Because I'm pretty sure I can for all these guys. I'd go to Skullman, but I hate his stage. There's, like, this one part that's a real pain. Oh, but the music in here is nice. Let's go to Skullman. Skullman's actually my favorite Robot Master, just design-wise. He's a badass. Ooh, he's a badass. Oh, man, that was so stupid. Believe it or not, I have a story. A stupid story, like a cringe story, about the fact that Skullman is my favorite Robot Master. You know how people always, like, talk about, like on Tumblr and stuff? People always get all up in arms about people, like trying to haggle, you know, fan artists for better commission prices, and it's, like, really fucking awful. And, like, I agree with that, but I did that once. It was when I was, like, I wasn't even that much younger than I am right now. It was when I was, like, 16 or 17, maybe. We went, me and my mom went to a Smash Bros. Melee tournament. And I had never actually played in a Melee tournament. I had never played Melee competitively before. I just wanted to play because I thought it would be fun, and it was being hosted by this local game store I really liked going to. So I practiced up with, believe it or not, fucking Ganondorf, and I got to the point where I could beat a level 9 Fox on Final Destination, so I felt pretty good. I felt pretty good for a newbie, which I knew I was, because I was playing as fucking Ganondorf in Melee. I wasn't going to win a tournament. There weren't no way I was going to win no stupid stinking tournament playing as Ganondorf. But we went to that Melee tournament, right? And, like, there were these, like, concessions, like, these little tables set up with people just selling wares. And one of the people there was, like, this young woman with a whole bunch of Perler beat art. Oh, I'm already, like, I don't even want to finish this story because it's so bad. It's so douchey. Oh, man. I can't believe I'm telling this story. I mean, it had to happen eventually. I'm glad it's actually happening in a relevant context. One of the Perler beats she had there was Skull Man. And I really liked Skull Man because he was, like, the coolest robot master. And it's not like I'm a fucking edgelord or something, but I just liked the way Skull Man was... I just liked Skull Man's design. When I played Mega Man 8-Bit Deathmatch, that was who I played as. I played as Skull Man. But... And I used... And you know what the worst part is? The argument I used for why I should get a discount... was the exact... I used that argument again later and for a completely different context. Like, I tried to say, like, oh, you should give me a discount because of the emotional connection I have to the character you've made Perler Beat artwork for. Therefore, nobody else could possibly... This won't mean as much to anybody else. Therefore, I should be the one to have it. Therefore, you should give me a discount. Like, that was actually my fucking logic. What a fucking asshole, right? But I think we fucking got it, because what the hell are you supposed to do when some asshole is like, oh, you should give me a discount, and they just won't let it go. That was me. I was that asshole. It happened again later. I went to Comic-Con. This might have actually been before. I don't remember. And there was another Perler Beat artist who had a picture of, it was the, from Kirby Superstar. It was the sprite of Kirby that appears on, like, on the file select when you've saved in the middle of Dynablade. Fuck! And I use that exact same argument, like, nobody else is gonna recognize that. Like, I'm basically belittling their fucking work. You know, I'm trying to say, like, you've really made my day, when really what I'm saying is nobody else will appreciate this except for me, so you should just give it to me. It's like, what a fucking cocksucker, you piece of shit! Ugh! Every single time I think about that, it's just like, there we go. Huh. That jump is actually almost as bad on the way back, so... But we got an E-tank. But is that that's my third E-tank. Where in the hell did I get 3 E-tanks? Well, one of them was just now, obviously, but... Fuck, go. Oh, get out of here. And then here's this, too. You gotta make this jump. We might actually... I was kind of hoping I would game over so that I wouldn't have to finish this stage, because we're almost up to time. I don't like making 20-minute episodes of Mega Man. It just feels like overkill. It's like, geez, are you trying to beat this game in 4 parts or something? Good gravy. Shit! Oh, man! Okay, you know what? I'm actually gonna end this episode here. Yeah, in the middle of a fucking I can't believe I'm doing this, but I'm actually gonna end this episode here because I don't want to go over 20 minutes because Mega Man doesn't deserve 20-minute episodes. The games are too short to have such long episodes. So I'll see you guys next time when we'll finish Skull Man, and I won't tell any more stupid stories, except maybe I will. Oh! No, that's the wrong keyboard. I don't have that one plugged in.